Single channel queuing system. Okay, single channel queuing system problem. We'll see. Here the problem is given like this. A grocery store has one checkout counter. Okay, single checkout counter. It is single channel queuing system problem. A grocery store has one checkout counter. Customer arrives at this checkout counter at random from 1 to 8 minutes apart. Okay, 1 to 8 minutes the customers will be arriving to the checkout counter. Okay, and each interval time has same probability of occurrence. Okay, arrival probability of occurrence is same. Okay, and the service time may vary from 1 to 6 minutes with probability given below. Okay, service time may vary from 1 to 6 minutes, and here the probability of service time has been given here, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, service time in minutes it is. Next is probability. Probability is 0.10, 0.20, 0.30, 0.25, 0.10, 0.05. Okay, this is the service time with probability. Okay, and use the following sequence of random numbers. It is given in the question. Use the following sequence of random numbers. That is, random digits for the arrival is 913, 727, 15, 948, 309, 922. That is random digit for arrival. And random digit for service time also is given in the question. That is 84, 10, 74, 53, 17, 79. Okay, this is random digit for service time. Okay, next here in the question, they have asked, simulate the arrival of 6 customers and calculate average waiting time for a customer. Next question, probability that a customer has to wait, probability of a server being idle, and average service time, average time between arrival. These are the things we need to find it, okay, after simulating the problem. Okay, this is the question. Okay, read the question carefully, understand the question, then we'll start solving the problem. Okay, here if you to start solve the problem, here the service time, arrival time has not been given directly here. Okay, but we need that service time and arrival time. Okay, so it is necessary to calculate them externally before constructing the simulation table. Before going for simulation table, we need to have the arrival time and service time. Okay, some problems they will give directly the arrival time and simulation service time. Okay, we'll see those type of problems also, where the arrival time and service time directly will give in the question itself. But in this question, they didn't give the service time and arrival time directly. Okay, to calculate the arrival time, here in the question it is given that customer arrives randomly from 1 to 8 minutes apart. They have given that the customers arrives randomly from 1 to 8 minutes apart, and each inter-arrival time has the same probability of occurrence. Okay, inter-arrival time probability is same. Okay, so in the question they have given that customer arrives randomly from 1 to 8 minutes apart. So we will calculate the probability, that is time equal to 1 divided by 8, will get 0.125. okay, that is the probability for arrival time probability we have calculated. Okay, next, first table which we need to construct is distribution of time between arrivals. Okay, that is the first table, time between arrival distribution table we need to construct here. Okay, here the time is given in the question, that is time between arrivals is 1 to 8 minutes apart, they have given in the question. So write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 to 8 minutes apart. Okay. Next, probability we have calculated, right? Each time distribution we have calculated, we got 1 divided by 8, we got 0.125. Okay. And it is same they have given in the question. In the question, they mentioned that each interarrival time has same probability of occurrence. Okay. So we write the probability as same for all 8 arrivals. That is 0.125. 0.125 for second, 0.125, 0.125, 0.125, 0.125, 0.125, 0.125. We'll write probability. Okay. After writing the probability, next which we need to calculate is cumulative probability. Okay. To calculate the cumulative probability, the cumulative probability will be the sum of previous cumulative probability plus present probability. Will get that present one's cumulative probability. But here the first arrival, there will be no previous cumulative probability. So we assume it as 0. So 0 plus 0.125. We will get 0.125. Okay. For the next arrival, the cumulative probability is 0.125 plus 0.125. Okay, this plus this, we will get this. Okay, 0.125 plus 0.125 will get 0.250. Okay. For next cumulative probability, the previous cumulative probability plus present probability. That is previous cumulative probability is 0.250 plus 0.125. Okay, addition of this and this, we will get 0.375. Okay, next cumulative probability. To calculate next cumulative probability, we need to add previous cumulative probability, that is 0.375 plus 0.125. Okay, we'll add these two, we will get 0.500. Okay, like that. Similarly, other cumulative probabilities also we need to calculate. 0.500 plus 0.125 will get 0.625. 0.625 plus 0.125 will get 0.750. 0.750 plus 0.125, we will get 0.875. Okay, 0.875 plus 0.125, we will get 1.0. Like this, we need to calculate the cumulative probability. Any doubts here? The cumulative probability we need to calculate. Cumulative probability is sum of the previous cumulative probability plus present probability. We'll get that present one's cumulative probability. Okay. Next column we need to calculate is random digit assignment. Okay. While assigning the random digit, always it should start from 1. Okay. And whether we need to assign the 3-digit random digit or 2-digit random digit, that will be depends on the probability. Okay, here we have taken the probability of 3-digit probability we have taken. Okay, so we will assign the random digit as 3-digit random digit. That is 0, 0, 1, 2. And it will end with the last value of cumulative probability. That is 1, 2, 5. Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5 for the first arrival. Okay, second arrival it is. It will start from 125 till 01 to 125. It is first arrival. Next, 126 to 250 second arrival. Okay, that is 250 we got it from the cumulative probability. Okay, next one, 250 will random digit will start from 251 to 375. Okay, 251 to 375. Next random digit assignment will start from 376 to 500. okay, 376 to 500. Next random digit is 501 to 625. Okay, next random digit is 626 to 750. Okay, next random digit is 751 to 875. Okay, next random digit is 876 to 000. Okay, we should not write as 1000. If you write 1000, it will become again 4-digit value. Okay, this range includes 876 to 999 plus 0. Okay, 0 also will be included in this range. Okay, 0 plus 876 to 999. These values will be included in this range. Okay, this is the distribution of time between arrivals table construction. Next one we need to calculate distribution of service time table. Okay, so service time here, the number of customers they have told that 1 to 6 customers. Okay, so in problem they have given the probability for the service time. Okay, arrival time probability they didn't give. So we have calculated by reading the question. But service time probability they have given in the question. You can see here. Yeah, you can see here service time probability is given in the question. Okay, service time 1 to 6 customers, the service time probability is 0.10, 0.20, 0.30, 0.25, 0.10, 0.05. Okay, you can write that probability as it is in the table. Okay, 0.10, 0.20, 0.30, 0.25. 0.10 and 0.05 probability we need to write it. Next we need to calculate the cumulative probability. Okay, the how we calculated for the arrival time cumulative probability, the same way we need to calculate here also. Cumulative probability we'll get it like addition of the previous cumulative probability plus present probability, we'll get the cumulative probability. For this first customer, he arrives at 0 time only. So he will not have any cumulative probability. So 0 plus 0.10, we will get the cumulative probability is 0.10. Okay. For the next one, the cumulative probability is 0.10 plus 0.20. We will get 0.30 as cumulative probability. Okay. Next one, 0.30 plus 0.30 will get 0.60 is the cumulative probability. Okay, for next one, 0.60 plus 0.25, we will get 0.85. That is the cumulative probability. Next one, 0.85 plus 0.10, we will get 0.95. Okay. Next, 0.95 plus 0.05. We will get 1.0. Okay. This is the way we need to calculate the cumulative probability. Cumulative probability will get it from addition of previous cumulative probability plus present probability, we'll get the cumulative probability. Understood, right? Next, we need to assign the random digit for this. How we assign the random digit? Here, the probability is given as 2-digit probability. So we should take 2-digit, okay, random digit assignment we need to take it. and always the random digit will start with 1. Okay, so 0, 1, 2. Here the cumulative probability is we got it as 0.10. So the random digit is 1 to 10. Okay, for the next one, random digit is, random digit will start from the 11. 11 to, its cumulative probability is 0.30. So it is 11 to 30. Okay, next one, the random digit will start from 31 to 60, because the cumulative probability is 0.60. For next one, the random digit is 61 to 85, because its cumulative probability is 85. Okay, next one, it will start from 86 to 95 is the random digit, because its cumulative probability is 0.95. Okay, for next one, the cumulative random digit assignment is, will start from the 96 to 000, because the cumulative probability is 1.0. Okay, we should not write 96 to 100 here. If you write it as 100, it will become 3-digit random digit assignment. Okay, here the range will includes 96 to 99 plus 0. Okay, 96 to 99 digits plus 0 digit will be added here in this random digit assignment. Understood, right? Service time calculation, distribution of service time and distribution of arrival time, we have calculated two tables. Next one, the table 3, we get it from the seeing the table 1. Okay, we need to determine the arrival time. Okay, some problems directly they will give the arrival time. Okay, but here they didn't give the arrival time, so we need to calculate it. Okay, and in the question they have given, the customers are 1 to 6 customers. So right here in this customer column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and for this customer arrival random digit is given in the question. You can see here. You can see here in this, random digits for arrival is given. That is 913, 727, 15, 948, 309, 922. Arrival for random digits for the arrival is given. Okay, that will write it here. Okay. Here, we will assume that first customer arrives at 0th clock time. So, we will not take any random digit here. Okay. Next customer, we will assign the random number given in the question. That is 913, 727, 15, 948, 309. Okay. From the second customer, we'll write the random digit for arrival. The first customer, we assume that he arrived at 0th clock cycle. Okay. Now, we need to, time between arrivals, we need to find it. Okay. The first customer, we assume that he arrived at the 0th clock time. Okay. So, we'll just leave the time between arrival for the first customer. Okay, second customer, the random digit is given as 913. Okay, 913 is the random number given in the table. Okay, now we need to check this 913 in the which range it comes in the distribution of arrival table, that is first table. Where the 913 will come in this first table? 913 comes in between 876 to 000. Okay, 913 comes in this range, right? In between the 876 to 999, 913 will come. So the time between arrival is 8 for that. Customer 2 time between arrival is 8. We'll write 8 here. Okay, understood, right? How we got 8? Okay, next random digit is given as 727. Okay, 727 in this distribution of arrival table. Yeah, where the 727 comes? 727 comes in this range of 626 to 750. Okay, its value is 6. We write 6 there. Okay, 727, it comes at arrival time 6. Next one is 15 random digit. Where the 15 random digit will comes here in this random digit assignment? 15 will be within this range, 1 to 125 range. So the time between arrival is 1. We'll write 1 there. Understanding right? Okay, we'll write 1 here. Next one is random digit 948. 948, where it comes here? 948 comes in between the range of 876 to 000. Okay, so its time between arrival is 8. Okay, we'll write 8 there. Okay, we'll write 8. Next time random digit is 309. Where the 309 will come here in this table? 309 will comes in the range of 251 to 375. Okay, its arrival is 3. So we'll write 3 there. Okay, we'll write 3. Understood, right? Like this, we find the arrival time. Okay, next we need to determine the service time. Here in the question, the service times are also given for the customers. Random digit for the service time also is given in the question. You see here, in the problem they have mentioned, given the random digit for service time. So that we need to copy there for all 6 customers. Here the random digit for service time is 84, 10, 74, 53, 17 and 79. This is the random digit for service time. That we need to write it here. Okay, customer 1 to 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 customers. Random digits are given in the question that 84, 10, 74, 53, 17 and 79. We just copy the random digit which is given in the question. Okay, now we need to determine the service time. Okay, service time, how do we find? We will use that service time calculation table. Okay, if where this 84 comes in this, which range we need to find first. Okay, 84 in this table 2. Table 2, the 84 came in the range of 61 to 85. What is the service time for this range? The service time is 4. Okay. So we need to write the 4 here. Okay, next random digit is given as 10. Where this random digit 10 comes in this table 2? Here, random digit 10 comes in between the range of 1 to 10. Okay, 1 to 10, the service time is 1. Okay, that one we'll write it there. Understanding right? Okay, we'll write 1 here. Next, 74 random digit. Where the 74 comes here in this table? 74 comes in between 61 to 85. Its service time is 4. So we'll write 4 there. Just write, we'll write 4. Next one is 53. Where the 53 comes here in this table? 53 comes in between the range of 31 to 60. For 31 to 60 random digit, the service time is 3. Okay. We'll write 3 there in the service time determining table. So this is 3. Next random digit is 17. Where the 17 comes in this table too? Comes in the range of 11 to 30. For this 11 to 30 random digit assignment, the service time is 2. We'll write 2 there. Okay, it is 2. Next, 79 random digit. Where the 79 random digit comes in this table to? 79 comes in between the range of 61 to 85. So its service time is 61 to 85. The service time is 4. We'll write 4 as the service time there. Okay. We'll write 4. Now we know the actual arrival times and service time for the each customer. Okay, each customer, what time he arrived to the system, we know. And what is the service time of that customer also, we know. Now we can construct the simulation table. Okay, the simulation table, the basic simulation table consists of customers, enter arrival time, service time begins, and if any waiting time in the queue, and service time ends, and time spent in the system and idle time of the server. How much time the server was idle is nothing but idle time of the server. So these are the basic things should be there in the simulation table. Okay. First, we'll write the customers. How many customers we need to simulate? We need to simulate it for 6 customers. So we'll write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 customers. Okay. And now we'll write the inter-arrival time. Okay. Inter-arrival times will get it from here. Okay. This is the arrival time that we'll copy here. First one, we assume that the first customer arrived at clock time 0. Okay. So 0, 8, 6, 1, 8, 3. We'll write it there in the table. Zero, 86183. Okay. Next, we need to calculate the arrival time. Okay. We know the inter-arrival time. We need to calculate the arrival time. Arrival time will be the previous arrival time plus the inter-arrival time. We'll get the arrival time. The first one, the previous arrival time is 0. Its inter-arrival time is 0. 0 plus 0, we will get 0. Okay. For the second customer, the arrival time is the first customer's arrival time plus its inter-arrival time. 0 plus 8, we will get 8. Okay. Next customer, 8 plus 6. Okay. Previous customer arrival time plus the present customer's inter-arrival time. Present customer's inter-arrival time is 6. 8 plus 6 will get 14. Okay. For the next customer, it is arrival time was 14. 14 plus its inter-arrival time is 1. 14 plus 1 will get 15 is the arrival time. 14 plus 1, 15. Next, 15 plus 8, we will get 23 is the arrival time for the customer 5. Okay. For next customer, customer 6, its arrival time was 6:23. Previous customer arrival time was 23. And the present customer's arrival time is 3. Okay. 23 plus 3. Its arrival time will come to know. That is 23 plus 3. Customer 6 arrival time is 26. 23 plus 3 will get 26. That is the customer 6 arrival time. Okay. You understood, right? Inter-arrival time we have copied from the table 3. Arrival time we calculated from the previous customer's arrival time plus present customer's inter-arrival time. We'll get that present customer's arrival time. Okay. Next one is service time. Service time also we have calculated here in that table 4. So table 4 we have determined the service time. Here the customer 1 service time is 4. Customer 2 service time is 1. Customer 3 service time is 4. Customer 4 service time is 3. Customer 5 service time is 2. Customer 6 service time is 4. It is 4, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4. Right, as it is in the simulation table. That is 4, 1, 4, 3, 2, 4. This is the service time. Okay. Now we know the service time, arrival time, inter-arrival time. Okay. Now we'll see what time the service begins. Okay. When the customer 1 arrives to the checkout counter at simulation clock time 0. Okay. That time system is free. Right. So whenever the customer enter to the counter, he will start, the system will start servicing the customer. Okay. So service time begins at clock time 0. Okay. And waiting time in the queue, is the customer 1 waited in the queue? No. Whenever he came to the system, he got the system and he's got serviced, started by the system. Okay. He was not in the queue. So it is 0 here. Okay. The service time ends. What time the service ends? Okay. He came to the system at clock time 0. Okay. His service time began at simulation clock time 0. And how much time he need to get his service done? That is 4 minutes. 0 plus 4 will get 4. Okay. The service ends at simulation clock time 4. Okay. Service time ends at simulation clock 4. Okay. Next is time spent in the system. How much time the customer 1 spent in the system? Okay. He was not in the waiting queue. So it is waiting queue time. Time spent in the system is waiting time in the queue plus the amount of time he spent for the service. Okay, that together is called time spent in the system. That is his queue time is 0. Customer 1 was not in the queue. So 0 plus his service time is 4 minutes. 0 plus 4 will get 4. The time spent in the system for 4 minutes. And idle time of the server. Did the server was idle? No. At clock, simulation clock 0, customer 1 arrived to the system. Immediately the system started servicing for the customer. So system also not idle for any minute, single minute. Okay. Next, the customer 8, customer 2 service time is 1. Okay. And customer 2 service time is 1. But what time the customer arrived to the counter? Okay. The customer 2 arrived to the counter at clock 8, simulation clock 8. Okay. And his service time is 1 minute is sufficient to get him serviced. Okay. So service time is 1. But he arrived to the checkout counter at simulation clock 8. Okay. So his service time begins at simulation clock 8. Okay, he arrives at 8. That time system is free. System was free from simulation clock 4. At simulation clock 4, it has ended the customer 1's service. Okay, at clock 8, the customer to arrive to the checkout counter. Okay, the system will start begin its service at clock 8. Is there waiting time in the queue? Did the customer too waited in the queue? No. Whenever he came to the system, that system was free. He got serviced immediately. Okay, and service time ends. What time it will end? Service will end. The service time begin at clock 8, and he need 1 minute to get it serviced. So it is service time ends at 8 plus 1. It is 9. Understood, right? Next one. Time spent in the system. How much time the customer to spent in the system? He came to the system at simulation clock time 8, and he needs only 1 minute to get his service done. Okay, so he was in the system for only 1 minute. He didn't waited in the queue. Okay, 0 plus his service time, waiting time plus service time. Waiting time is 0. His service time is 1. 0 plus 1, it is 1. The time spent in the system is for simulation clock time 1 minute. Okay. Next, idle time of the server. How much time the customer, how much time the server was idle here until the second customer come for the service. Okay. Here, the server, the system completed its service at the simulation clock time 4. At clock 8 only, the other customer 2, arrived to the system. So 8 minus 4, it is 4 minutes the system was idle. The server was idle. Understood, right? Next, at clock time 14, okay, customer 3 arrived to the system. To him, to get serviced, he need 4 minutes to get serviced. When he come to the system, the server will start executing his whatever request, okay, service. Okay, 14 clock time 14, he arrived to the system. That time system was free because system ended its service at simulation clock time 9. Okay, at 14, customer 3 came to the system. So at service time simulation clock 14, the system will start servicing for the customer 3. Okay. Did the customer waited in the queue? No. Whenever he came to the system, system was free. So he got serviced immediately. Okay. And the service time ends. At clock time 14, the service will begin. And for the customer 3, service time is 4. 14 plus 4, it is 18 minutes. Okay, 18 minutes, the server will end servicing the customer 3. Okay, and time spent in the system. Customer 3, time spent in the system. That is waiting time plus service time. He didn't waited in the queue. So it is 0. The service time of customer 3 is 4. 0 plus 4, it is 4. And how much time the server was idle? Okay, until customer 3 came to the system. Here, the service, customer 2 service, it completed, server completed at clock time 9. Okay, simulation clock time 9. At simulation clock time 14, the customer 3 came. So 14 minus 9, it is 5 minutes. Okay, 5 minutes, the server was idle. Okay, next one, customer 4. Customer 4 arrived to the checkout counter at simulation clock 15. Okay, his service time is 3 minutes. Okay, what time the service will start for the customer 4? Because to complete the previous customer, the system will take simulation clock time 18. Until simulation clock time 18, system can't serve for the customer 4. So the customer 4 will be waiting in the waiting queue until the simulation clock time will become 18. At simulation clock time 18, his customer 4's service time will start. Okay, and he waits for 3 minutes. That is 15 clock time he will come to the counter, checkout counter, but that time server was busy. Server was busy for 18, simulation clock time 18. Okay, so 18 minus 15, it is 3 minutes. 3 minutes the customer 4 will be waiting in the waiting queue. Okay, what time the service will end? 18 minute at the simulation clock 18, his service will start and it will take 3 minutes to get customer 4 to get serviced. So 18 plus 3, it is 21. Okay, at server time, server will end servicing the customer 4 at simulation clock 21. Okay, how much time the customer 4 spent in the system? That is his waiting time plus his service time. He waited in the queue for 3 minutes plus his service time is 3 minutes. 3 plus 3, it is 6. Okay, and idle time of the server. Did the server was idle for any minute? No. Until the customer 4 arrived at clock time 15, but the server was busy serving to the customer 3 till simulation clock 8. Okay, so server was not idle. So it is 18 minus 18. Its service ended at clock simulation clock 18 minutes. And it started the customer 4 at simulation clock time 18. 18 minus 18, it is 0. Understood, right? Next, customer 5. Customer 5 arrives to the system at 23, simulation clock time 23 minutes. Okay, at 23 minutes, he will arrive to the system. That time, and he needs 2 minutes to get serviced. Okay, at 23, whether the server is busy? No. Server ends the customer 1's, customer 4's service by simulation clock 21. Okay, at 23, the server, customer 5 came to the checkout counter. So immediately it will start customer 5's service. Okay, server will start servicing the customer 5 at whenever he came to the system. That is clock time 23. Okay, service time begins at 23. Okay, did the customer waited in the queue? No. Whenever he came to the checkout counter, immediately his service got started. So he was not in the queue. So it is 0. Next, what time the service ends for the customer 5? Customer 5 service started at simulation clock 23. He needs 2 minutes to get serviced. So 23 plus 2, it is 25. Simulation clock 25, the server will end servicing the customer 5. Okay, how much time the customer 5 spent in the system? That is waiting time plus his service time. He didn't wait in the queue. So 0 plus his service time is 2. 0 plus 2 is 2. Okay. Next, how much time the server was idle? Okay. The server finished the servicing the customer 4 at simulation clock time 21. But at simulation clock time 23 only, the customer 5 arrived. So 23 minus 21. That is 2 minutes the server was idle. Okay, next customer arrived at clock time 26, but he need 4 minutes to get serviced. Okay, when he arrived at 26 simulation clock time, that time the server was free because the server completed servicing the customer 5 at simulation clock time 25. Okay, at simulation clock time 26, the customer 6 arrived to the system. And its customer 6 service will begin at simulation clock time 26. Did the customer 6 was waiting for the system? No. Whenever he came to the checkout counter, immediately the system server was free. He got his service got started at simulation clock 26. And what time the service will end for the customer 6? That is, his service began at 26 simulation clock time plus he needs 4 minutes to get it done, service done. So 26 plus 4 at Sinovation clock time 30. He will customer 6 will end. Customer 6 service will get done by the server. And how much time the customer 6 inside the system, that is waiting time plus service time. He was not in the queue. So 0 plus 4, it is 4. And how much time the system was idle, server was idle. Server completed servicing the customer 4, customer 5 at simulation clock time 25. Customer 6 arrived to the checkout counter at simulation clock time 26. Okay, 26 minus 25, it is 1 minute the server was idle. Okay, understood, right? And here we have calculated the service time, total service time. 4 plus 1 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 4. We got 18 here. And total waiting time. Waiting time, only one customer was waited in the queue. That is customer 4. That is for 3 minutes. So that is waiting time is 3. How much time total the customer spent in the system? That is 4 plus 1 plus 4 plus 6 plus 2 plus 4. That is 21 minutes the customer spent inside the system. And total idle time of the server, that is 4 plus 5 plus 0 plus 2 plus 1, that is 12. Okay, total, the 12 is the total idle time of the server. And in the question problem, they have asked some few questions. That is average waiting time for the customer. Average waiting time for the customer, we need to calculate by using the formula called total time the customer waits divided by total number of customers. Total time the customer waited in the queue for only 3 minutes. 3 divided by total number of customers, that is 6. The 3 by 6 will get 0.5 minutes. That is average waiting time for the customer is 0.5 minutes. Next, probability that a customer has to wait. Okay, that will be calculated by the formula total customer who waits divided by total number of customers. Total number of customers who waited in the queue, only one customer waited in the queue. That is customer 4. You can see here, only one customer waited in the queue. That is customer 4 waited in the queue. So 1 divided by 6. That is 0.166. That is probability they have asked. So we, in the percentage, if you write, that is 16%. Probability that a customer has to wait is 16%. Okay. Next question in the problem they have asked is probability of a server being idle. Okay. That will be calculated by the formula called total idle time of the server divided by total runtime of the simulation. Okay. Total idle time of the server is what? Idle time of the server is? This is idle time of the server. Total idle time of the server is 12. Okay. That is total runtime of the simulation is what? How much time the simulation was running? Simulation clock time, till the what time the simulation clock was running, that is till 30, simulation clock time 30. Okay, that 12 divided by 30. Okay, total idle time of the server is 12, total runtime of the simulation is 30. 12 divided by 30, it is 2 by 5, that is 0.5. It is asked as a probability of a server being idle. So it is 40%. Okay. Not only that, here the probability of server being busy is the complement of the server being idle. Okay. So if the server being busy means busy's complement is idle. Okay. Here we have calculated the idle time. Okay. 1 minus idle time will come to know how much, what is the probability that the server being busy will come to know. That is 1 minus 0.4, it is 0.6. That is 60% of the time the server was busy. Next question was asked in the problem was average service time. Average service time will be calculated by the formula total service time divided by total number of customer. Okay, total service time, how much we got here? Total service time is 18. Okay, 18. Total service time is 18. And 18 divided by total number of customers is 16. 18 divided by 16 is 3 minutes. Average service time is 3 minutes per customer. Okay. Next, average time between the arrivals. That will be calculated by the formula sum of all times between arrivals divided by total customers minus 1. Okay. Sum of all times we got 26 divided by total customers minus 1. That is 6 minus 1 will get 5. 26 divided by 5, 5.2 minutes. Okay. Why we have removed that total customer minus 1 means the first customer arrives at 0th simulation clock time 0. Okay. So we calculate as total customers minus 1. We'll get the average time between arrivals. Okay. Next one is average time a customer spends in the system. That is total time customer spends in the system divided by total number of customer. Total time, how much the customer spent in the system? How much time the customer spent in the system? That is total time the customer spent in the system is 21. Okay. 21 divided by total number of customers is 6. 21 by 6 will get 3.5 minutes. Okay. Next one, next question asked in the problem is average time the customer spends in the system. Average time the customer spends in the system is average time the customer spends waiting in the queue plus average service time of the customer. Okay. Average time the customer spends in the queue, we have calculated, we got that 0.5. Average time the customer spends in the system, we calculated here. Okay, that is 0.5 minutes. That we'll write it here. Plus average service time of the customer. Average service time of the customer is 3 minutes. Okay. This plus average time the customer spends in the system will be calculated by sum of average time the customer spends in the waiting queue plus average service time of the customer. That is 0.5 plus 3 will get 3.5 is the average time the customer spends in the system. Okay. This is about simulation, first simulation problem, that is this is single channel queuing system problem. Okay, this is the first simulation problem we have seen. Okay, we'll see the other problems in next session. This is single channel queuing system problem.